In this video, I will show you how to create a 360 environment in Element 3D. Let's begin! Once you have the layer with Element 3D effect added, head over to the scene setup. Inside Element 3D, we will first create our 360 background. Go to Create and create a sphere. Go and select the sphere's material. Now, let's add our 360 background image. Under Diffuse, select the Non-Set box, and then select the Load Texture box. Now, find and select the 360 background image you want to use. When ready, press Select Texture. Once in this window, select OK. You should now see your 360 image applied to your sphere. Now, we are going to need to make some adjustments to this texture. In Basic Settings, under Diffuse, make the value 0. In Illumination, select the Use Diffuse Color box. And under Intensity, make it 100. Now scroll down to the Advanced Settings, and under Visible to Reflections, unselect that box. Do the same for the Cast Shadow, Receive Shadow, and for Ambient Occlusion Mode, make it be Ignore. Now, it's important to have the Draw Back Faces box selected. Otherwise, you won't see inside the sphere texture once we scale it. Once you have done all that, it's time to scale our sphere. Select the sphere model and under Scale, set a value that you feel works for your scene. For me, I'll always do 10,000. Perfect! You should now see your 360 background image. If it looks pixelated like this, it could be because the draft texture box is selected. Unselect that, and you should now have a clear image. I am going to rename this model Background. Perfect! It's time now to create the floor. Head over and press the Create button. You can use a square plane. However, I like to use a cylinder. I prefer round corners. I am going to make some adjustments to the cylinder so it can work as a floor. I will change the height to the lowest value. For this, it'll be 0.01. For radius, I'll make it 10. But you can decide what best works for you. Now it's time to add my floor texture. I will select the cylinder material, and in its texture tab, under Diffuse, I will select the box that says Non-Set, and then select the box Load Texture. Now I will search and select my floor diffuse texture. Then I will press the Select Texture button. And then, OK. I will do the same process for the glossiness. Reflectivity. Normal bump. And occlusion textures. Perfect! Our floor is now set. Let me scale the floor a bit more. I'll select my cylinder model, and under Scale, I will make it 200. This looks better. I am now going to rename this model Floor. From here on, you can add any of your own models. For the sake of this tutorial, I am going to use a basic sphere as my model. I will change the alignment to be bottom. Now I am going to add a texture. I will go to the Preset tab, and in Materials, under Physical, I will select the texture. I want a sphere to reflect the outside world, so I will click and drag it to the sphere. If you see your sphere turn black, don't be alarmed. That's because we need to set what 360 background we want the sphere to reflect. To do that, we need to create an environment. Head over and select the Environment button. Now, go and select this box here. And right here, we are going to search and select the same 360 environment we use for our background. Once you found it, press the Select Texture button. Press OK on this window. Perfect! Your 3D model will now reflect your 360 environment. We are not done yet. As you can see, the sphere is not reflecting the ground model. It's only reflecting the 360 image. We want the sphere to reflect the entire scene, not just the background image. Let me get closer so you can see what I mean. Having the model selected, we are going to head over to the Reflect Mode section. And under Mode, we are going to change it to Spherical. Perfect. Now the sphere reflects the entire scene. If you wanted to place another 3D object, you will see it in the reflection of the sphere. If you want to have more control over your scene, you can also assign each of these models to their own group and assign each one of them a null layer to adjust them individually. For the sake of this tutorial, I am going to leave them in the same group. Once ready, head over and select the Exec button. Now, let's create a camera so we can better view our scene. I'll leave the settings as is and press the letter C in my keyboard to maneuver around the camera controls. You can see how the scene perfectly interacts with the camera. However, there seems to be an issue. You can see the sunlight is coming from here. However, when we see the reflection of the sphere, the sun is also in the same position. The sphere is not perfectly reflecting the scene. The sun should be reflecting in front of the sphere and not in the back as you see here. We will need to fix that. Select the E3D layer and head over to the render settings. And in physical environment, head over to the rotate environment. And under the Y rotation environment, we are going to make that 180. Perfect! You can now see the reflection of the sphere now matches the 360 environment it's reflecting. This looks great! It's time to add some shadows. I will go to Layer, then New, and then Light. I will make sure it's a parallel light. I will make the light color be similar to what the light in the background image is. That looks close enough. I will make sure the cast shadow box is selected. And press OK. I will now activate the shadows in Element 3D to guide me on where to position the light. Head over to the Element 3D settings. And in Shadow, make sure to have the Enable box selected. Perfect! Now I will match the light source to match the background. This looks good, but I feel that it could be better. So I will head over to the Lighting section in Element 3D, and under Add Lighting, I am going to make it be Sunset. That's much better. I will now go to activate the ambient occlusion and set the intensity to 8 and the SSAO contrast to 1. This looks great! Now I want to add some fog to the scene to blend the floor to the background. Head over to the fog controls and enable the box. I will change the color to match the background photo. A medium gray color works well. I'll play around with the fog range to where I feel it looks good. and I will adjust the fog start distance to what I feel looks right for my scene. That looks good. And lastly, I'm going to add a depth of field effect. I will drop down the camera layer controls, and in camera options, under depth of field, I will turn it on. I will increase the aperture. I'll make it 100. And for the focus distance, I'll start at 1000. Let me adjust it a bit more. And there you have it. You have now learned how to create a 360 environment in Element 3D. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.